prior allegiance to a place that I was happy to be born into. Two kids with some pretty serious emotional issues had sex in a trailer in Bucyrus, Ohio, and 9 months later I came out. I've never viewed that as a cause for celebration. From what I've seen, a mourning would be more appropriate to the death of the hopes and dreams of those two kids. Years later, I found myself climbing up on top of the jewelry store on Sandusky Avenue, and I let my toes hang out over the ledge and think about jumping off out into the street. And I daydream about who would find my body and who would come to my funeral. But I'm trying really hard not to think like that anymore. Now I sat down to try and write something beautiful, but the truth is I don't have anything resembling beauty inside of me. And that's a hard realization, that I am just a lost generation. I am a real live American throwaway. And now most nights I lie awake in bed worrying that I'm a sociopath, and then I worry that I worry so much about that. I throw these social and digital Hail Marys out into the ether, because my family doesn't get me, and my friends, they don't either. And I sat down to try and write something beautiful, but the truth is I don't have anything resembling beauty inside of me. And that's a hard realization, that I am just a lost generation. I am just a real live American throwaway. And so, like most stories you've ever heard before, I thought I'd start at the beginning.